It's you. Have you brought me an eel?
Not yet, but I'll keep trying.
I must be careful now.
What's going on?
Yeah! watch each other's backs!
Thank you.
Liga era Geras.
Some sort of armed camp there.
Let's hear a story.
In my youth, I remember hearing the story of Kulda, a fierce young woman whose father forbade her from swordplay and raids. Kulda had skills to match or surpass any man in the clan. And so it was that her beloved Garpi asked her aboard his ship. Once again, Kulda's father forbade her to leave, calling her soft and weak and fragile. But Kulda ignored these insults and left. For a full spring, Kulda and Garpi sailed the coast of Francia, raiding and plundering and taking much silver and riches. Then, in the early weeks of summer, a passing ship gave Kulda the news that her mother had died suddenly. Kulda was grief-stricken. Kulda returned quickly home, only to find her mother there, alive and standing quietly beside her father. Kulda was confused.
Hold on.
I've heard all Danes are cursed with slow brains and fat tongues. Care to prove me wrong?
Most men choose to be loud or stupid. Impressed that you manage both. I will take you on.
Brilliant. Some flighting spirit. How about a wager?
Here.
Thank you.
Let us begin.
I have sparred against champions and bested each one.
Prepare to taste bitter defeat once our battle is done.
Oh, ho, ho, terrible. You're a misfit, a halfwit, a foolish old grouse.
You're a weakling, a milksop, a catcher, a louse.
Brilliant! I'm the greatest of flighters, a master of verse.
Your pride is appalling, and your rhyming is worse.
Got you there, young Irv. Ha! I'm impressed. You are as sharp as that axe on your belt.
As promised, I will have my winnings now.
Take the gold. You've earned it.
Hello there. I can always use more of that. Leaving already? Shame. This would look very fetching. You wouldn't regret getting this. Yes, this will look very good. It's just your style. I hope to see you again soon.
I'm off. Be well, friend.
see us. I've not seen a cow. If I...
could this possibly be? You knock your arrow into the bowstring, pull it back, aim and fire. Try again. Lord, save us all if we ever have to rely on you lot to defend us with bows. Remember, faint aim never won fair battle. Again.
No use running.
I did.
What marvelous aim. For a moment, I thought my training was getting into these thick skulls. See if you can hit one of the targets above. Ooh. That was sound aim. Amazing.
That was a fluke. I bet it was.
Yeah. I bet you can't hit that, that chicken. Right over there. The one hanging from the pole. Go on, then. Hit that hanging chicken from here. No cheating.
Huh. To hit that chicken would require some kind of special technique.
Oh, that's mad!
Extraordinary! That was true skill and aim. On the mark! Well, friend,
You can count on us to lend a hand against King Constantine and his well-paid Picts. And thank you for showing these turnips some skilled marksmanship. Visit us again. As for the rest of you, keep practicing!
You're finished! Too slow!
Easy, friend. You will be avenged. Our bodies may be broken, our pouches may be empty, but our souls will thrive. You will be remembered.
What happened here?
An attack gone awry. We found more of Constantine's Picts than expected. The rich have their numbers, both in coin and spears. My men were not ready, and we were overwhelmed. But I'm afraid it's not over. They know I still live. Hark! Pict reinforcements! To battle! The spirit of my men are with me, and my spirit with them!
The threat is gone.
What a fight! The Pict King Constantine will feel a little lighter in the purse tomorrow. Thank you for your aid,
Call me Eivor.
The name's Reacher. Reacher Sherwin. You know, we could use someone like you in our band of merry rogues and knaves. The poor get richer and the rich get poorer, thanks to us. We've a hideout in the woods. Drop by sometime. Share an ale, maybe.
Maybe.
Well, until we meet again.
A hideout in the woods. Sounds interesting.